Samantha from Electrical ASMR. And today I'm going to be doing a get ready with me video. So my hair is still a tiny bit damp, but we're just gonna let that be damp. But we're gonna do my makeup, which is very simple, very light. I'm actually gonna put on some BB cream today because I have a few breakouts, nothing crazy, but just like I break out around my chin whenever I'm stressed, or like when I have a lot of stress, not when I'm stressed, but like when there's a lot going on in my life as far as stressful things. So don't forget to give this video a thumbs up and subscribe if you haven't already. I'm gonna be uploading twice a week, on Wednesday and on Saturday. So first, I don't know what's in these boxes. I keep makeup in these Birch boxes, which just has all of my daily stuff in it. I don't know what's in, I have four of them, and I don't know what's in what box, so. We're just gonna open them all and kind of set them around you. Sorry if the camera shook a little bit there. A little table over here too, if you see anything, that's what I'm doing. Okay, so I got this as a sample from my Birch box. So I've been using it. I don't normally use face primer, I only use eye primer. But I've been using it, so it makes my face feel really smooth. But I'm all moisturized and just so smooth. Okay, we're gonna have to put this hair away. I'm gonna try to make some good sounds for you. We're gonna just kind of like a mixture between like a yellowy skin tone and a pink skin tone. Is that a neutral skin tone? I don't know. I'm not a beauty guru. But I use samples because I get Birchbox, so I collect samples basically, and I just use them because my skin's not very sensitive. So I have this stuff, which I've been liking. It's about to be empty, I think. And then I tend to hold on to them until they're basically like, I can't even squeeze out a drop more. Because I don't have to buy any BB cream, because I don't use foundation. I just use BB cream whenever I need any kind of coverage. I'm not that worried about it being like perfect coverage. If I am, I'll put a little concealer. As much out that we can. Oh, that one's too much. And then I just basically rub it over my hands and just put it on my face like lotion. on camera, it might not even look like it does anything to my skin, honestly. I don't use a beauty blender or anything. I rub nice and gentle. I'm not like rubbing the hell out of my skin. I open my mouth all the time too, so you're gonna see my tongue ring like all the time. I'm just gonna tap it around my eyes. We don't wanna pull on that. I feel like this is kind of like my time when I really, besides in the shower and when I'm moisturizing and stuff, it feels like the time when I'm kind of like getting blood to the surface, which brings nutrients to the surface. And really, God, I make some funny faces when I'm doing my makeup. I never noticed before. So I'm okay with like really massaging. Just kind of blend it. Whatever's left on my hands, which is basically nothing, I just kind of blend it into the ear area and like the back, like here. And just kind of massage it all around and just to kind of like give myself that nice look. Okay. Paper towel again. Just to get some of that off. I don't set with powder or anything. The only thing I do is, I have this blush, which I got this as a sample from Birchbox, which is not even a sample, it's a full size, when they very first started. I want to say I was one of the first subscribers to Birchbox, because I remember about 6 or 8 months after I subscribed, they, like, had an email of, like, 1 million subscribers, so I was like, well, shit, I was, like, at the beginning, not, like, first, but, like, you know, within the first probably 100,000 subscribers, which I feel like is really early since they've been around for like 5 or 6 years now, and I've had them for like 5 years. So I got this at the very beginning and I love it. I've literally had this for 5 years, and I don't wear a lot of foundation or any of that, so I just like it because it just keeps my face from looking like monotone. And it's like got this nice peachy undertone. You probably can't even tell the difference on my face. I can tell a difference, but I just kind of blend that into my hairline, basically. Just kind of gives me a little color. I don't contour, I do highlight sometimes, when I do, let's see, this is a matte bronzer, which I'll use sometimes if I'm feeling really pale, by Hoola, which I just got not that long ago, by Benefit, I guess, I don't know, I'm not a music guru, I almost said, I'm not a makeup guru, so, but this is the highlighter I've been using, which, you guessed it, I got it as a sample, because I don't buy anything except for mascara, basically. And I just use the same brush and just kind of dip it in, and I'll just highlight right here, just a tiny little bit, nothing crazy. And then I'll dip my finger, and I'll usually do my nose, just a little cupid's bow, maybe a little here. That same brush and just soften it all up. And then usually I'll do also my jawline just a tiny bit, just because I like to emphasize, because I have a diamond shaped face, so this is like the highest point in my face right here, these points, so I like to bring the jaw out a little. I feel like I have a pretty slender, like right here, like I have my cheekbone, it's pretty obvious where my jawline is, so I don't really contour, but and then I'll just, while I'm here, I'll just tiny bit on my finger, and I'll just pop that here, just a tiny bit. So I'm, like I said, I'm really going for like a more natural, I'm gonna need a different mirror, a more natural look. Okay, so that's basically it for my face wise. It's basically it face wise. So then, this is one thing I do buy, which I've been using forever. Urban Decay Primer Potion. I don't know. I used to really like makeup, so I used to watch a lot of beauty gurus. I don't anymore because I don't wear makeup anymore, really. Only like this much. Like this, what I'm gonna do today is like maximum makeup that I use. I don't ever wear more than this, basically. Unless I'm like going out to like a any kind of concert. I like rock music and EDM mostly. My boyfriend likes rap too, so he's been making me, but it's not bad, I guess. It's alright. I used to hate it, but it's growing on me. Because I really like EDM, and you know, rap is like it's okay. We're growing. It's growing on me slowly. Okay. So then I've had this Estee Lauder palette. I think my mom gave this to me for Christmas a long time ago. But I really like it. It's missing these two little guys. I'm guessing they fell out or I broke them or something. I don't know. But it's all nudes. Nothing exciting. All nude colors. And then when I'm feeling frisky, I have a couple of other palettes that I just basically make nude eyes with them. This one I dropped and I broke some of it. This is the Coastal Scents Warm Palette, which I use when I'm feeling frisky or just like want a different color. Like I'll like change my neutral eye up for like winter or summer or spring. That's about as much as it goes. Then I have this palette, which I have a lot more makeup. Like I have a lot more palettes. I have all of the Coastal Scents 88 color palettes because I used to be obsessed with them, and so I have a ton of them. I gave some away to a friend of mine. I used to collect MAC makeup, which I don't know what I was thinking. It's way overpriced. But, you know, I was young. This one's got way more colors than I'll ever use. Ever. So if you're looking for like a good palette that has a ton of colors, the pigmentation is great in my opinion, and it's relatively cheap. This one I want to say it's like $25, but it's got 88 colors, and it's got like a little bit of neutrals, here and here, and then all these colors in the middle. It comes with a little mirror and these little guys, which I don't use. It's dirty, obviously. It's a great palette for that. It's got a lot of different colors. If you're looking for one on a budget, I want to say it's like $25. But if you're lucky, they go on sale sometimes, which is how I ended up with all of them. Okay, but we're going to just do a regular old Estee Lauder palette. Because this is what we like. These nice colors. Maybe we should do eyebrows. I always do eyebrows last. Okay, so typically I take like a nice flat, what is this called, a shader brush, but this one's like a pretty big one. Pretty big one. And then I normally start with like this neutrally color here. I think I'll use this mirror. And I just basically press that in here, like so. I don't really do a whole lot of blending at this point because I'm just kind of pressing just to kind of build that color up. Maybe you can see closer. This light over here kind of washes my eye out a little bit, and then I just turn the brush the other way and just like that, and I'm just kind of blending that up here and to this part of my lid, just kind of blend that in. And it's like my base lid color, and then I usually just whatever's on the brush, I just bring that down like this, just to kind of blend that out. I'll do the same thing on the other side. Load the brush up, pop it in, just pop it right there. I just tap it. I usually just tap the brush. I need to actually tap it though. Okay, and then I'll just kind of start on this outer corner and just kind of blend. blend that up, and I feel like I got more shadow on this other eye. Sorry. This lighting is not what I normally do my makeup in. I actually normally do it in my kitchen. I have a little desk table because my kitchen's small. I mean, it's actually a good size. It's pretty small, but it's like a square. And they're supposed to be like, I would say it's made for like a two-person dining table on the side, but I don't use that area for a dining table because we don't sit at a table. Like, there's no need for us to have a table. But I have a 6-foot table there with like a nice tablecloth on it or whatever. And I basically sit there and do my makeup and I do our bills, and that's where the mail goes. And I have some like cooking magazines, because I cook all the time. There. And that's typically where I'll sit and do my makeup. Okay. Then I just take this fluffy brush. And I'm blending the edge, basically. I use the same brushes for everything. I'm basic like that. I'm not trying to do anything crazy here. So this is where we are. Just... where we are. Not too crazy. And then I typically will go in with this like coppery darker color here, and just on the tip of the brush, boop, boop, just like that. And I just kind of put this in that lower corner, like so. Just pop that in there and kind of bring it across, blend it across like that. Blending, and we're blending, so you just get this kind of like illusion here. Now we just blend. Blend, blend, blend. If that's anything I ever learned from all those beauty gurus, it's blend your makeup, girl. Blend your makeup, girl. This video is gonna be like a big version. A big my personality video. This eye just looks darker because there's more light coming over here. Man, it just looks a hot mess right now. But it's okay. It all comes together in the end, I promise. So we just blend. And if you get too much, you just kind of take this brush and brush over it. Really does help to blend. Here's where we are right now. We're just got that slightly darker outer corner here. It doesn't really pick up on the camera that much. But like I said, it's very light. I don't do a lot of makeup. I typically am very natural. I don't really go for heavy, heavy makeup. So we kind of have this like natural blendy thing going on here. Sometimes, not very often, I go a little bit darker right here, but not very often. Okay, so typically what I do next is I take this shade right here and I just get a little bit on the tip, right on the tip, and I bring that in here. Just gonna blend that in. It just kind of brightens the inside of my eye a little bit. swear my mouth's gonna be open for this whole video. This is where we are. And I'll just take and with this brush and just blend this out here. A little bit more. And then you can take your big fluffy brush and just blend like that. Okay, then what I do, I don't wear eyeliner either. Very rarely. I'll take this last dark brown, not even black, I know, and I just place that on my lash line, basically, as if I was wearing eyeliner, but much softer. And then what I do is I take this brush, it's like basically another shader brush, but smaller, and I just blend this in, like that. So we're basically just blending. That's why some days I do a little darker in the outer corner. And then I just kind of swoop this under the eye. It's kind of got a little funny thing going on right here. But normally I'll add a little more brown. And then like darker brown to the outside just to kind of blend it a little more. A little bit more. This is kind of messy. It's because it's not in the right lighting. And normally it's not quite so down. Not quite so dark. Okay, that's better. Basically what I typically look like. And we'll do the same thing on the other side. Just kind of pressing this into the lashes here. Blend it a little bit. This eye turned out much better. That's how it typically goes for me though. And again, one more round. Because we don't want it to look like a line. We just kind of want it to be like a darkened area. And then what I'll do is I'll take this, like, the base color again. And I'm just going to press that over to help to blend that dark color in. Light, nothing crazy. And then same over here, we'll just basically whatever's left on the brush, just kind of swoop that underneath. Just to kind of give that illusion. And then we'll take our big brush and just blend out this under eye. See, it's coming together, I told you. To warn you, my cat is making some funny moves. And then, for the eyebrows, depends on how I'm feeling. But typically, I'll take this same, like, dark brown shade and just kind of... Wait, if I do this in the camera, this is bad. Okay, and I'll just basically, I start on the outside and I'm just basically trying to make a shadow of where my eyebrow is. I don't do any shaping, really. I just am basically putting a shadow of my eyebrow onto my skin using eyeshadow. So yeah, that's all I'm doing, pretty much. So, pretty easy. You can see it's just a tiny bit darker than my other eyebrow. And that's just to help fill in some of like the sparser areas of my eyebrows, but they're not too terrible. I say on a scale of 1 to 10 of eyebrows, I may have like a 6 or a 7. They're not the worst eyebrows in the whole world, but certainly not the best. I have a friend who has spectacular eyebrows. Aren't we all jealous of that person? I'm like, yeah, that's cool. I wish I did. Eyebrows are better than no eyebrows. So cool, Dad. Then I just take the little end of this spoolie and just kind of brush it out. Make sure there's no harsh lines. Make sure I don't leave any weird trails. It's coming together. And then the last and the most important thing of all is the mascara. I need to buy some new mascara. All my mascaras are not doing so great. I have two here of the same one, but I never remember which one's the old one and which one's the new one. So I'm just using them both at the same time, and well, you know, that's how it goes. So then I just kind of give it a swirl. I don't do a lot of ins and outs because that's how you get air in there, and that's how that gets bad. So put some mascara on my little eyeballs. Well, not on my eyeballs, on my eyelashes. If I were to put it on my eyeballs, that would hurt. I've done it before on accident and poking. Ah, no fun. I'm weird, I'm sorry. And then I just do the other side. I have my mouth open for everything but mascara, because I'm thinking about it now. I kind of do my mascara from a downward angle. So, oh, there's the mouth open. This really helps. I need new mascara, hardcore. Okay, and then before I dip it again, I will just put a little bit on my bottom lashes. But not a whole lot. Just literally like the tiniest amount. Swap to the other one since I don't know which one's good and which one's bad. And then we'll go in for a second coat. Just like this. bit more on the bottom, just a tiny bit. This wasn't really quite enough. But we just don't want spidery eyelashes. Some people like that, and it's a look. But for me, it's just to create that shadow on the bottom. That's it. Okay. So there's mascara. Oh, that was loud. I'm sorry. Okay. So that is mascara. The only thing I would ever really have left would be lips. And for me, typically it's like tinted chapstick that I'm gonna wear. I like, there's a Burt's Bees. I don't have it with me right now. I don't know really where it is, honestly. Look how. I don't know where it is. Typically, I just throw on some like light, it's like a baby pink, but it's just tinted chapstick basically. But I think for this video, we might actually put some, lipstick on. But I have had this pencil sharpener, apparently it was made in Germany. I have had this tiny pencil sharpener since I was in like sixth grade, and this bad boy. So we'll put some lipstick on just for the hell of it, because I just wear lipstick around the house. I don't ever wear it out. I think I've worn it out like maybe, I used to wear it a lot, so I have a shit ton of lipstick. I'm actually gonna make like a lipstick capping, I'm gonna make like a makeup video basically, not like this, but like a, not doing my makeup, but just like going through all my stuff. So yeah, I used to wear lipstick a lot, like a couple times a week, but now I put lipstick on and then I just get annoyed with it, so I take it off before I go. But first, that's a look. Another thing that I don't really buy, that's a look too. Just that upper lip lined. Another thing I don't buy is lip liner. Oh man, I'm looking attractive right now. That lip liner, I just, it's not for me. I just fill in my whole, all my lip with lip liner anyway. I don't love this lip liner. I got it in my Birchbox. I gotta say that like this so I know I'm on my lip. I got it in my Birchbox. I wanna say like maybe 2 months ago. I don't hate it. Just that upper lip. It just kind of gets really sticky. Which, is that a good thing with lip liner? Is that a good thing? I don't know. I don't wear it, so I couldn't tell you. Is that overlined? I feel like there's more. Oh yeah, I used to have my lip pierced. I feel like there's still more lip there, but if I go any bigger, my lips will look overlined. Like way over. See, look at that. So sticky. I guess it holds on your lipstick really well. Are we looking even here? I don't know. Looks pretty alright to me. I don't know. Okay. Well, that's the liner. Anyway. It's called, it's Nude by Lipstick Queen, and so it's a little lip liner. I kind of like, I love the color, but, and then I got this, I want to say last month, which is by Locke, and it's called Rose to the Occasion Vibrant Matte Lipstick. So, I'll put that on over the top of this. I feel like I made this a little weird. I was gothic when I was a teenager. I went through a gothic phase. And I didn't wear black lipstick. I did, like Halloween, I would go all out. With the whole gothic thing, basically I was a vampire every year, still to this day. Not every year. But yeah, what do you guys think? So this is my, actually I would never wear this lipstick out. I think it looks okay. Like I like the color of it. The formula's nice, smells really good, which is weird for a lipstick but to smell good, but I just feel like it draws a lot of attention to my mouth. Maker. So yeah, this is it, my whole get ready with me. I hope there were some good sounds in these boxes, me soft speaking rather than whispering. I whispered a little, but I mostly soft spoke. And I tried to make some sounds, but mostly just me being silly. So. Okay, guys, thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to like and subscribe. If you want to see more content from me, I upload twice a week, Wednesday and Saturday.